So we are here continuing our visit to the Wolfsburg Park in Germany with Volkswagen, and we're with Thorsten, who is one of the main persons in charge of the tour of the factory. So thank you for having us here, Thorsten.
You're welcome.
So this is not only one of the largest factories in the world, but also it's an historic place here in Germany, right?
That's correct. The factory was built in 1938, before the Second World War broke out, to manufacture the Beetle here in Wolfsburg. But of course, before any Beetle could have been produced, the Second World War was started. The factory was forced to produce military equipment in the first place. It was rebuilt when it was destroyed in 1945. It was rebuilt by the British authorities. British military government was rebuilding this place. The factory was operated by Major Ivan Hirst at that time, building first about 20,000 Beetles on behalf of the British forces before the civil Beetle production was started. That was December 1945.
Yeah, and since then it's become again one of the largest automobile factories in the world.
That's correct. The factory in Wolfsburg, if you count this factory as one factory under one roof, is the largest automobile producing factory in the world.
Yeah. So we just did a tour like an hour and a half, and we just saw like 1% of it.
That's correct. So there are now more than 900 different departments at this factory. So to see them all would mean to stay here for at least 4 weeks. That means the 1% that we saw was, of course, the production of what we call our bread and butter car, which is the Golf. So we are making here in Wolfsburg approximately 2,200 Golf a day on behalf and order of a certain customer. So all those cars are pre-ordered already by one certain customer.
Oh, that's amazing. And the rate of production is incredible. So it's like 19 seconds? Every 19 seconds a car gets out of the factory?
That's correct. There are four assembly lines at this factory. Two for the Golf, one for Touran and Tiguan, and a fourth line only for the SUV Tiguan. So considering the fact that there are 19 and a half hours of production time a day, and we are assembling almost 4,000 cars during the time, that means that every 18 seconds a finished car leaves the production of this factory.
Yeah. Amazing numbers, starting with the amount of people who work here. We're in Wolfsburg, the city of Wolfsburg, that is around 120,000 people, and half of them work here?
Yeah, that's very interesting. I mean, the town of Wolfsburg did not exist before the factory was built here. The factory became known as the automotive factory nearby the town of Fallersleben. Yeah. Hoffmann von Fallersleben was riding the national hymn. That's quite an old town, Fallersleben. But the town of Wolfsburg simply grew by the employees working for this factory. I do come myself from Brunswick, which is not far from here. Brunswick is already twice the size of Wolfsburg, but since Wolfsburg is a very young town, it's today 130,000 people. I think that's not bad for a young town like this.
Yeah. So you're in the middle, I mean, you're always improving the factory, adding things, modifying things, but like, so in the historic part of it, you cannot touch the buildings, right?
That's correct. All those buildings are protected by law on a governmental issue, which is called German Heritage. That means these are listed monuments, which we might not touch on the outside. We might not remove the workshops. We might not extend them. So even the latest technology has to fit somehow inside these protected workshops, which is quite an enormous challenge for those departments planning all that.
Yeah. So one of the additions to the production line now is the e-Golf and the GTE, right?
That's correct. The GTE is the very first Golf plug-in hybrid. Ever since 5 weeks, we are manufacturing now the Golf GTE in Wolfsburg. And of course, we're very proud since all those cars, the electric Golf, the GTE, the fuel stratified injection, the TDI engines, are all getting manufactured on the same assembly line. That's the advantage that we have today with the modular system, the modular transverse matrix, which is going to be used in the future for all mass-produced cars of the Volkswagen Group, where the engine is simply assembled transverse in direction to the driver's direction.
So that means here in that production line that we just visited, we saw like live left-hand right driving car, right? Left-hand driving car. all in the same production line and at the computers, the robots and everything, like, know exactly what's going on.
Yeah, that's correct. A friend of mine used to run the visitors department in Hanover at Volkswagen Commercial Plant, and he's Brit, and he told me that there are 53 rice-dairying nations worldwide, and all those nations get served here locally from Wolfsburg.
Wow, that's amazing. So, even though this is a very industrial factory, there are like some little touches of nature here and very important with the environment, right?
That's correct. There is, for example, one project to the north of the factory that was renaturing of the factory. A project to renaturize this area, to give the nature a bit back of what we took from the nature when the factory was built here. There we are simply creating a very certain area with very old buffaloes, for example, living there. So that's a renaturizing project. In addition to that, we are running in the factory a project which is called the Energy Way, apart the commitment of the factory to save energy during the car production already, because until 2018, during 8 years only, we want to save 25% of the energy consumption for the production of every car.
Can you give us some examples of how are you achieving that?
The key word is recuperation. That was an example that we took from the Golf Electric. The electric Golf is braking whenever you are not having your foot on the throttle. So it breaks down to regain energy every time you are driving to a crossing, for example.
Okay.
So in the same way, we are breaking down the production to regain energy. That's, for example, the braked gravity carrier, which is a conveyor below the ceiling transporting the freight downwards at an angle of 1% on its own gravity. And just like a dynamo, it gets braked to regain energy during this process. There is, for example, an elevator every time the body shell needs to be lowered to the beginning of a production line. This elevator moves down the body on its gravity to regain energy as well. So at the end of the line, every seventh turn up again for the body shell is for free.
Very intelligent, very, very ingenious thing. So let's go back a little bit to the way that you produce cars here, and it's non-stop here, 24/7, even though the production line is for 19 and a half hours, there's something else happening during that downtime.
That's correct. There's service maintenance during the day already. Several times a day we're stopping the car production to do that service. That's a fixed time which is calculated through the entire day already by our technicians, mechanics, IT professionals, to do service on the machinery. And after all, we are manufacturing our cars from Sunday evening to Sunday and to Saturday afternoon, because from Saturday afternoon there's the reset of production before the next production week then gets started finally.
So basically there's always something happening here.
That's right, it's like New York City, it's the city that never sleeps.
Never sleep. So being here next to the Autostadt that we visited yesterday, people can come and visit the factory too?
That's correct. Today it's possible not just for customers picking up their cars, but simply for everybody. It's possible to plan a factory tour at the Volkswagen factory in Wolfsburg. Either the specialized factory tour, especially for universities, for suppliers, for journalists just like you are, but also for any VIP guests, but also for private purpose. So if you are living somewhere nearby and you're having yourself some private guest, you might reserve a factory tour for us, for a specialized factory tour around the plant.
Yeah, and then you see really amazing things here in the factory. For example, there's obviously a lot of people working here. Don't worry, this is a factory, so the noise is part of the story.
That's right.
So you see a lot of people working here, but there's also a lot of automation process, right? Like, you see a lot of robots here. It's like science fiction movie.
Well, that's right. I mean, it's worth automating steps to safen the process. So it wouldn't be worth investing a lot of money to automate the processes if we would assemble like 50, 60 Golf a day. But when assembling about 2,200 units of the Golf a day, it makes sense to save the process, to avoid any malfunctions. So especially where we need employees who are trained in a very certain way, you might also have the effect that the employee might get sick all of a sudden. If that employee is not present, we've got a great problem to replace him. So at these processes, we are automating the production just like we saw it today, simply to improve quality and to reach a standardized quality level during the car production.
Yeah, and also not only the robots, there's like this conveyor system that goes on its own, and the little trains that nobody is driving, or like obviously someone is controlling behind the scenes, right?
That's right. The route trains are used for the future of logistical transfer in the production. The route train makes it possible to unload material without the assistance of a forklift truck. It is a project of the factory. The forklift truck free factory means that we are transporting the freight absolutely just in time to the places of work. We're keeping the storage of parts at the place of work rather low, since we do not have to wait anymore for a forklift truck to unload the freight, and that saves us valuable space at the limited space of this protected and listed monument today.
It's amazing how many things happen here at all time, and it's really great. So finally, we have like a minute. If people want to come and visit here, where should they look for information, and how can they go and arrange a visit to the factory?
Well, there is a Volkswagen website where you might also find some additional information about the factory tour in Wolfsburg. There's also a link to all factories here in Germany to reserve a factory tour. And you might reserve the factory tour, especially the specialized factory tour, directly on the email address werktour@volkswagen.de.
Very easy. So we're going to post it on our website also, so our fans can have it there. Well, Tristan, thank you very much for the visit, and we're going to keep enjoying. And now we're going to go out of the next step of the visit here, and we're going to actually go and drive some of the cars that just got out of the factory here, right?
All right, enjoy that, most late. Great meeting you. Have a nice time. All the best for you for the future, and until next time.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah.